The purpose of this video is to review rational exponents. Our goal is to be able to manipulate and simplify expressions using rational exponents. Before we do that, let's take a look at the basic properties of exponents. You should be familiar with these, but let's go ahead and review them anyway. If we're multiplying and the bases are the same, the rule is that we should add our exponents. For example, if we have 2 raised to the third power times 2 raised to the second power, 2 plus 3 would give us 2 to the fifth power. A common mistake is to multiply the bases together. That would be incorrect. Another common mistake is to multiply your exponents, and that would not be correct either. Here's an explanation of why. 2 to the third, of course, is 2 times 2 times 2, multiplied by 2 to the second, and we can see very easily there are 5 factors of 2. Rule number 2, if you're dividing and the bases are the same, the rule is you should subtract your exponents. An example of this, again, would be 2 to the 4th divided by 2 to the 2nd. 4 minus 2 would give us 2 to the power of 2. If we take a look at it in more detail, 2 to the 4th power divided by 2 to the 2nd power, we can easily see that there are some common factors and we're left with 2 to the power of 2. Rule number 3, if you have a power raised to a power, the rule is to multiply. So for example, if I have 3 to the second power raised to the third power, the rule says I multiply 2 times 3 to get 3 to the sixth power. If I'm not sure, I can convince myself. I know that if something is raised to the third power, then that means I'm going to multiply it by itself 3 times. And from here, you can kind of visualize you do have 6 factors of 3. The last rule is how to deal with a negative exponent. If I have 5 raised to the power of negative 2 and I want to simplify this, I always like to put this over 1. If this crosses the fraction bar, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. This is equivalent to 1 divided by 5 raised to the second power, or 1 over 25. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at rational exponents now. The main goal is to be able to apply this definition for a variety of purposes. Now what I want you to watch out for is, if you have a base raised to a fractional power, the denominator tells you the index of the radical. So we want to be able to convert rational exponents to radical form. The numerator of the rational exponent would be the exponent. Now notice how the exponent can be underneath the radical sign, or it can be outside the radical sign. Let's take a look at a couple examples. First thing I notice, I have the cube root of x. There's no exponent on the x, so I would probably put a 1 there just to remind myself that is x to the first power. That way I can easily write this in rational exponent form. So what I'm doing is I'm going from this form here to this form here. The index tells me the denominator of my rational exponent, and the numerator is going to be the exponent. X to the 1/3 is equivalent to the cube root of x. Next example is very similar. This should be r to the 2/5 power. Now on letter C, notice there's no index. I want to have an index so I can apply this definition. And since it's a square root, of course we know that it's going to be an index of 2. Therefore, this would be x to the power of 8/2, which of course simplifies to x to the 4th power. One last example. This would be b to the, again, the index is 3. That's the denominator of my fractional exponent. So this would be to the 5/3 power. If I really wanted to, I could rewrite this by moving this up into the numerator, and that would be b to the negative 5/3 power. Okay, let's apply this rule in the opposite direction. Now we're given an expression with a rational exponent, and we want to simplify it. And the way we're going to do this is we're going to rewrite it in radical form, and then simplify it from there. The key here, again, the denominator tells you the index. This is a cube root. The base is our radicand, and the numerator, 4, is our exponent. Now, 8 is a perfect cube, so the cube root of 8 is 2, 2 to the 4th, which of course simplified to 16. We can easily verify this on the graphing calculator. Let's do that. I'm going to go ahead and just type in 8 to the power of 4/3. Now, when I type in my exponent, since it's a fraction, I do need to include it in a set of parentheses. And that verifies my... Let's try one more. Convert it to radical form. Now my denominator is 4, so this is the 4th root of 81 raised to the 3rd power. The numerator of our fractional exponent is 3. Now, this one's a little more challenging, possibly. If I take a look at 81, 81, of course, is 9 times 9, but 9 times 9 is 3 times 3. 81 is a perfect 4th root. So the 4th root of 81 would be 3 raised to the 3rd power, which is 27. Let's check this one as well. And that verifies. This was a very quick review of rational exponents, but I hope it helps, and I hope you have a good day.